Professor Dave again, let's talk about volume.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned how to calculate the two-dimensional area covered by the surface of a three-dimensional object. But sometimes we want to do more than that. Sometimes we want to calculate the three-dimensional space that is contained within that object, which we can think of as the amount of water we will need to fill up the object if it were perfectly hollow. Just the way the area of a square is found by running a side length across the shape. If we take that square surface and run it across a third dimension, we can get a cube. A cube is a prism with squares for all its faces. To find the volume of a cube, instead of just squaring the side length, which gives us the area of one square face, we cube the side length to get the volume of the cube. With a side length of 2 meters, this cube has a volume of 8 meters cubed, or cubic meters. We can easily visualize this by saying that if we have some 1 by 1 by 1 cubes, or cubic units, it will take 8 of them to fill this larger cube. For a rectangular prism, it's just length times width times height. 2 times 3 times 5 gives 30 cubic meters. What we are really doing is calculating the area of the base and multiplying by the height, as though running the base up through the height of the shape to span its volume. This works for any type of prism, like a triangular prism. Here we have triangular bases, so we just get the area of one base and multiply by the height. If the triangle itself has a base and height of 2 and 3 meters, and the prism has a height of 10 meters, we get 1/2 2 × 3 × 10, or 30 cubic meters. This works for cylinders too. It's always just base times height. The base of a cylinder is a circle, so we find the area of this circle and then multiply by the height of the cylinder. If the height is 6 meters and the radius is 3, we get pi r squared, or 9 pi times 6, or 54 pi cubic meters. Now let's move on to some trickier shapes. How do we calculate the volume of a pyramid? This will be different from a prism because we can't just multiply the base times the height, as the triangular faces slope inward. Instead, we will use the formula 1/3 base times height. So if we have a square pyramid, which has a base with a length of 3, and the pyramid has a height of 5, we get 9 for the base, times 5 is 45, times 1/3 is 15 cubic meters. What if we don't know the height of the pyramid, but only the height of the triangles? Luckily, we know the Pythagorean theorem, so we could imagine a triangle where one leg is the height of the pyramid, the other leg is half the length of the base, and the hypotenuse is the height of a triangular face. We plug them into the equation, and we can then solve for the height. So it's just one extra step. Cones work just like pyramids. Again, it will be 1/3 base times height, except that here, the area of the base is given by pi r squared, so we get 1/3 pi r squared h. If we have 2 for r and 9 for h, we get 4 pi times 9 is 36, times 1/3 is 12 cubic meters. Lastly, we need to be able to calculate the volume of a sphere. The formula for this is 4/3 pi r cubed. So with a radius of 3, we cube it to get 27, divide by 3 to get 9, and multiply by 4 to get 36, times pi is 36 pi cubic meters. These are most of the regular shapes for which we have reliable equations to calculate volume. There are, of course, many irregular shapes that have a more unpredictable curvature, and to calculate the volumes of these, we will need calculus. We aren't there yet. We have lots more algebra to learn first, and since we've wrapped up most of the crucial topics in geometry, we are safe to go back to equations with variables, right after we check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.